Hello students, I am Mrs. Kavita Modi. Today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter 13, Simple Interest. Students, tell me, if you keep 1000 rupees in your piggy bank, does it become increase after 1 year? No, it still remains 1000 rupees. But if Dhruv keeps 1000 rupees in bank, after 1 year, it will become rupees 1100. Means Dhruv get extra 100 rupees for keeping his money in bank, which is safe too. This extra money is called interest. Today, our topic is simple interest. The simple interest formula is given by simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by rate of interest multiplied by time. Or in short form, we can write it as SI is equal to P multiplied by R multiplied by T. So the simple interest we calculate depends on three factors. Number one, principal. Number two, rate of interest. Number three, time. Let's study these terms. The first is principal, or in short form, we can write it as P. Principal is not our school principal. Principal is the money we deposit in a bank. The amount of money deposited in a bank or borrowed from a bank is called principal. Deposit means to keep. Withdraw means to take away or remove. Borrow means to take something temporarily and returning it later. And loan is the act of borrowing money from the bank. The next is time, or in short form, we can write it as T. The period of time after which money is withdrawn is called time. Or in other words, the period of time the money is deposited or borrowed. Remember, the simple interest is always found in years. If the time is given in months or days, convert the time into years and then find the simple interest. If the time is given in months, divide the time by 12 because 1 year is equal to 12 months. And if the time is given in days, divide the time by 365 because 1 year is equal to 365 days. The next is rate of interest, or in short form, we can write it as R. So the extra money paid by or charged by the bank for every rupees 100 after 1 year is called rate of interest. When you deposit money in a bank, the bank usually pays you for the use of your money. And when you take out a loan from a bank, you have to pay the bank for the use of their money. So in both cases, the fee charged for use of money is called interest. It is usually expressed as a percentage. So what is interest? The extra money paid by or charged by the bank is called interest. Rate means percentage. So rate of interest is equal to percentage of interest. So the extra money paid by or charged by the bank for every rupees 100 after 1 year is called rate of interest. To understand it in a better way, let us solve some questions. Question number 1. Find the simple interest at the end of 1 year for rupees 400 at 5% interest per annum. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 400, time is equal to 1 year. And rate of interest is equal to 5%. And we know that 5% is equal to 5 upon 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to P multiplied by T multiplied by R, where P is equal to principal, T is equal to time, and R is equal to rate of interest. Now put the value. See, principal is equal to rupees 400. So write down rupees 400. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Then time is equal to 1 year. So write down 1. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Then rate of interest is equal to 5%. and 5% is equal to 5/100. So write down 5/100. Now simplify. Cut 20/20. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. 5 4s are 20. So we get rupees 20. So simple interest is equal to rupees 20. Let us solve one more question. Question number 2. Find the simple interest at the end of 1 year for rupees 1800 at 12% interest per annum. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 1800, time is equal to 1 year and rate of interest is equal to 12%. And we know that 12% is equal to 12/100. So write down 12/100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to P multiplied by T multiplied by R. See, principal is equal to rupees 1800. So write down rupees 1800. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Then time is equal to 1 year. So write down 1. Again write multiplication sign as it is. Then rate of interest is equal to 12/100. So write down 12/100. Now simplify. Cut 20/20. Now we have 18 multiplied by 12. Do the multiplication. We get rupees 216. So the simple interest is equal to rupees 216. Let us solve one more question. Question number 3. Find the simple interest at the end of 1 year for rupees 2500 at 4.5% interest per annum. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 2500, time is equal to 1 year and rate of interest is equal to 4.5%. 4 1 upon 2 is a mixed number, so let's convert them into improper fraction. 4 2s are 8 and 8 plus 1 9, so we get 9/2%. And if we remove percentage symbol, divide by 100, so we get 9/2 multiplied by 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to P multiplied by T multiplied by R. See, principal is equal to rupees 2500. So write down rupees 2500. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Then time is equal to 1 year. So write down 1. Again write multiplication sign as it is. And rate of interest is equal to 4/1/2%, which is equal to 9/2 multiplied by 100. So write down 9/2 multiplied by 100. Now simplify. Cut 20/20. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 225/2. If we divide rupees 225/2, we get rupees 112.5. So simple interest is equal to rupees 112.5. The next is question number 4. Find the simple interest at the end of 1 year for rupees 3200 at 6/1/2% interest per annum. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 3200, time is equal to 1 year and rate of interest is equal to 6/1/2%. 6/1/2 is a mixed number, so let's convert them into improper fraction. 6 2s are 12, 12 plus 1 13, so we get 13/2%. If we remove the percentage symbol, we get 13/2 multiplied by 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to P multiplied by T multiplied by R. Now put the value. See, principal is equal to rupees 3200. So write down rupees 3200. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Then time is equal to 1 year. So write down 1. Again write multiplication sign as it is. And rate of interest is equal to write down 13/2 multiplied by 100. Now simplify. Cut 20/20. See, 2 and 32 both are divisible by the same digit 2. So divide. 2 1s are 2 and 2 16s are 32. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. 16 multiplied by 13, we get rupees 208. So simple interest is equal to rupees 208. Let us solve one more question. Question number 5. Calculate the simple interest on rupees 600 at 7% interest per annum for 2 years. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 600, time is equal to 2 years and rate of interest is equal to 7%. If we write it as fraction form, debt is 7/100. And simple interest, we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now put the value. See, principal is equal to rupees 600. So write down rupees 600. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 2 years. So write down 2. Again write multiplication sign as it is. Rate of interest is equal to 7/100. So write down 7/100. Now simplify. Cut 20 by 20. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 84. So simple interest is equal to rupees 84. Next is question number 6. Calculate the simple interest on rupees 500 at 81.2% interest per annum for 2 years. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 500, time is equal to 2 years, and rate of interest is equal to 81.2%. And 81.2 is a mixed number, so let's convert them into improper fraction. 8 2s are 16 and 16 plus 1 17, so we get 17/2%. If we remove the percentage symbol, divide by 100, so we get 17/2 multiplied by 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now put the value. See, principal is equal to rupees 500. So write down rupees 500. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 2 years. So write down 2. Again write multiplication sign as it is. Rate of interest is equal to 17/2 multiplied by 100. So write down 17/2 multiplied by 100. Now simplify. Cut 20 by 20. See, 2 is divisible by 2. So divide. 2 1s are 2. Again, 2 1s are 2. Now, it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. 17 5s are 85. So we get rupees 85. So simple interest is equal to rupees 85. The next is question number 7. Calculate the simple interest on rupees 3000 at 12% interest per annum for 3.5 years. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 3000. Time is equal to 3.5 years. 3 1/2 is a mixed number, so let's convert them into improper fraction. 3 2s are 6 and 6 plus 1 7, so we get 7/2 years. And rate of interest is equal to 12%. Now write it as fraction form, that is 12/100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now put the value. See, principal is equal to rupees 3000. So write down rupees 3000. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 7/2 years. So write down 7/2. Again write multiplication sign as it is. And rate of interest is equal to 12/100. So write down 12/100. Now simplify. Cut 20 by 20. See, 2 and 12 both are divisible by the same digit 2. So divide. 2 1s are 2 and 2 6s are 12. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 1260. So simple interest is equal to rupees 1260. Next is question number 8. Calculate the simple interest on rupees 2500 at 7/1/2% interest per annum for 2.5 years. See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 2500. Time is equal to 2.5 years. 2.5 is a mixed number, so let's convert them into improper fraction. 2 2s are 4 and 4 plus 1 5, so we get 5/2 years. And rate of interest is equal to 7/1/2%. Again, 7 1/2 is a mixed number, so let's convert them into improper fraction. 7 2s are 14 and 14 plus 1 15, so we get 15/2%. And if we remove the percentage sign, divide by 100, so we get 15/2 multiplied by 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now put the value. See, principal is equal to rupees 2500. So write down rupees 2500. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 5 upon 2 years. So write down 5 upon 2. Again write multiplication sign as it is. And rate of interest is equal to 15 upon 2 multiplied by 100. So write down 15 upon 2 multiplied by 100. Now simplify. Cut 20 by 20. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 1875 upon 4. If we divide rupees 1875 by 4, we get rupees 468.75. So simple interest is equal to rupees 468.75. Let us solve one more question. Question number 9. A man deposited rupees 4500 in a bank, which paid him an interest of 11% per annum. How much simple interest will he get at the end of 5 years? See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 4500. Time is equal to 5 years and rate of interest is equal to 11%. Now, write it as fraction form. That is 11 upon 100 and simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now, put the value. Principal is equal to rupees 4500. So write down rupees 4500. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 5 years. So write down 5. Again write multiplication sign as it is. Rate of interest is equal to 11 upon 100. So write down 11 upon 100. Now simplify. Cut 20 by 20. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 2475. So simple interest is equal to rupees 2475. The next is question number 10. Rahul borrowed rupees 650 from Sohan at 8% interest per annum. Find the simple interest Rahul has to pay Sohan after 4.5 years. In this question, principal is equal to rupees 650. Time is equal to 4.5 years. See, 4 1 upon 2 is a mixed number. So let's convert them into improper fraction. 4 2s are 8 and 8 plus 1, 9. So we get 9 upon 2 years. Rate of interest is equal to 8%. Now write it as fraction form. That is 8 upon 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now put the value. Principal is equal to rupees 650. So write down rupees 650. Then write multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 9 upon 2 years. So write down 9 upon 2. Again write multiplication sign as it is. Rate of interest is equal to 8 upon 100. So write down 8 upon 100. Now simplify. Cut 10 by 10. 2 and 8 both are divisible by the same digit 2. So divide. 2 1s are 2 and 2 4s are 8. Again, 4 and 10 both are divisible by the same digit 2. So divide. 2 2s are 4 and 2 5s are 10. 5 and 65 both are divisible by the same digit 5. So divide. 5 1s are 5 and 5 13s are 65. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 234. So simple interest is equal to rupees 234. The last question is question number 11. Ramlal borrowed rupees 3000 from Arun to purchase a tractor. Arun charged him an interest of 4.5% per annum. How much simple interest will Ramlal pay to Arun after 3 years? See, in this question, principal is equal to rupees 3000. Time is equal to 3 years and rate of interest is equal to 4.1/2%. And 4.1/2 is a mixed number. So let's convert them into improper fraction. 4 2s are 8 and 8 plus 1 9. So we get 9/2%. If we remove the percentage sign, divide by 100. So we get 9/2 multiplied by 100. And simple interest we have to find out. We know that simple interest is equal to principal multiplied by time multiplied by rate of interest. Now put the value. Principal is equal to rupees 3000. So write down rupees 3000. Then write the multiplication sign as it is. Time is equal to 3 years. So write down 3. Again write multiplication sign as it is. And rate of interest is equal to 9 upon 2 multiplied by 100. So write down 9 upon 2 multiplied by 100. Now simplify. Cut 20 by 20. See, 30 and 2 both are divisible by the same digit 2. So divide 2 1s are 2 and 2 15s are 30. Now it cannot be further divisible. So do the multiplication. We get rupees 405. So simple interest is equal to rupees 405. I hope the concept of simple interest is clear now and you are able to solve all the word problems on your own. Thank you. Have a good day.